aspect is that you have to kind of like do what you can to feed. So treatment writing, I was a writer. I love comic books, I love movies, you know. Hey, bounce ideas off me. The director will probably say, yeah, I want to do this and I want to do that. But then he would need a person like myself as a treatment writer to put it all into that format for shooting. That's why you may be treatment writers, just to start out and get on.
Did you ever carry on making music videos when you came back over here?
Yeah. Anybody ever heard of like Kof? Young Kof? Right. I was doing his videos and got him onto Channel U and all that other kind of stuff, the early stuff that we did. And like the deal is the fact that like great artists work with a new artist, Miss Dolly Now, you know, who looks like she's gonna go somewhere. But everybody else in between was like, hey, you do Wu-Tang, you can do mine. I'm like, oh really? How much money you got? I got 5 cents. 5p. Yeah, I'm ready to go, man. We're the girls, we're the life. I don't know, where are they? Yeah. You know? And then that's where, you know, for you guys, I really recommend you, like, you gotta focus on this. What the artists never did, because they didn't have management or producers who usually think that way as far as selling themselves, they never did was realize that no matter what video you do, it could be a camera person shooting you in a club, right? You got a MySpace, you promote it. Why are you promoting it? Yeah, but how do you get them? If you just shoot any old band and any old live gig somewhere, like at the Contemporary Center or at the Zanzibar, what are you actually showing your audience as the artist?
What they're paying for.
What?
What they're paying for.
Oh man, you're not thinking hard, guys. What are we doing? Like, if you're a band, right, what do you need people to hear?
Music.
Your music. How are they going to hear it if you don't shoot it? Right? So really, I could shoot you with a paper cup and a light, right? And it shouldn't matter how crappy it is because people think your music is dope. They think your song is dope, yeah? They think you're good. So it shouldn't matter. But now, if you're a visualist and you wanna really go into it, like, hey, I wanna put the camera angles, I wanna get cameras here, I want one over here, get a wide shot, I wanna get the audience so I can cut away, I want this good coverage, yeah? Now, you're working as a director, right? But you don't do that off of just any old Tom, Dick, and Harry band, do you? Not somebody who nobody cares about. So, if they have a MySpace and they have a following, yeah, then you know that those following people are going to see that video. If you're any good, if you listen to anything I said here about production value, right, you would be better, right? If you think about any of the elements I talked about today, about why you're going to shoot what you shoot, whether you're a treatment writer or not, right, then more people will be listening to that video or watching it on YouTube because it's free. Yeah? So record labels, the reason why they don't exist here, because they're unnecessary. People will download your stuff on YouTube, Twitter, Facebook, all that other kind of thing. But if the band sucks, they won't. You know, if the band is not a band, but your mates, then who cares? So you put the production value into something that's worth putting it into, that you're upping them to the next step. If your mind is malleable enough, right, that means if you are filled with enough knowledge of books, TV, movies, radio, comic books, manga, anything, right, then all of that will infect whatever thoughts come out of when you hear someone's song. If you don't care about any of that stuff, then, you know, think about another job. Like, let's see, what could I do here? I could do like a sew, right? Like a shop, I could do that, right? Don't think about directing, because a director has those kind of abilities to be creative off of all of the different built knowledge that they have in their head. Do you understand? You might think it's worthless that you read comic books, but it's not. You might think it's worthless that you cry at old movies, but it's not. Because if you do, somebody else does. Right? And the main thing about that But you know, like, when something is familiar, right? Like the older guys in there, right? When something is familiar to you, right? And retro-wise, you see it, right? You're going to go back to that memory of when that was familiar. Now, the younger ones will probably not actually have that memory, but it'll be in their head because your parents were watching that self same thing. And you not gonna walk around thinking about underdog, right?
It's cartoon.
Right? Hong Kong food. Right? But see, you are. And it's gonna come up for you. Because I just said it, or I just showed it to you. And you're gonna go, oh yeah. That was fun. I don't know why I'm laughing at that, actually. Right? You are, because it's cellular memory.
It's like most of the Wu-Tang video, the sensor on the Shaolin sort of style. So.
Yeah, well, because what they did was they looked at that market. That market was nowhere in existence when they were doing it. But in the 70s, all of the people like in the hood outside were watching kung fu movies, martial arts, Bruce Lee, Jackie Chan, right? It was a phenomenon. So when Wu-Tang came out, you know, remember, you know, it's funny though. If you actually did the history, right, you know, Genius actually came out with an album, right, where he had like the high top fade and he had the bone age clothes and stuff like that, you know, looking like Kwame or something like that. And RZA was called Prince Raheem wearing like a tuxedo in this first video, right? And you would like go, that's impossible, yeah, because of the image they built up for themselves. But that's how they first came out, but they were signed. And then they realized this ain't working for us, man. They got their cousins and their brothers and everything, and they did protect your neck, you know? And what they did was they like started to wear like, you know, baklavas and big hoodies and, you know, started going out and portrayed the role of the whole Wu-Tang phenomenon. And it blew up massively. So you never know. Whatever kind of quirky ideas you have, you never know what's gonna hit. That's the whole point. The whole point is don't follow the trend of what's already out there. Right? Why would you want to be pink? Pink is pink. Yeah? You don't want to do that. You want to be red or purple. What would be the purple hand? Yeah. All our hands are purple. Yeah. You know? In the video, we have to have a purple steam. Everything is indigo. Anyway, I got one more video to show you and everything. This was like the most expensive video. Which is Wu-Tang Sons of Man video that we shot in Miami. And this last one I'll show you guys.
How much was it?
$300,000. I love that.
Illegal refugees known as Sons of Man have been captured by bringing the numbers here at the tribunal.
Black power, destroy the real McCoy on the roof.
handing out garbage. Low welfare with no healthcare. The pain is felt here. They deceive even TVs. Turn the end to a species. Won't be to see the government raise rent. Birth control pills, we own mills. Let's take it back to the Applejack attack. Before they shot the blacks, we was above things. We was hungry, now we drug things. Shoot the open our bloodstream. Another thing, another dream. When they feed us all, coming up to me with three fours. Trying to get me free more. But you know, pre-stores, and knowledge is a free course. Keep your knees cold. I can see more come. Talk when I was young, by the holder, brushing off my shoulder. Instead of being militant, feminine, guilty, and innocent. Rap black is a nationalist. Niggas killing with that fashion. Shh. Claiming profits, it ain't real with their topics. Claiming worldly knowledge. You get toast like the Thomases. And it's a promise, kid. Your English will get buffin'. Based on like David, then roughin'. You're out the blue. And still ain't nothing new. And the sun's whipping, even as it was written. As it was written. Of your production, self-destruction of the son of man. Never thought that alien would eventually make plans hand in hand. East of black man, woman, and child. Juveniles, but before dedicated to black and sound. Young East and liberated, some deceased and separated, not educated. Waited out there, they didn't have a latest ruthless and precision. Islam, my definition. The coalition makes solid product, watch decisions. States, listen to fiction, out of jurisdiction. Too late to listen, I want you burn with competition.
A lesson in extravagance, really. You know, if you say, yeah, what was the meaning behind the pool scene and everything like that? Because we could, you know? I mean, all of those like famous DJs in Florida and everything like that, you know, when sometimes, you know, that's what you probably wanted, that's the level you want to get to. When you just had too much money to do too much with, you know? And that's pretty much where we were. It's like, you know, we shot in Miami, we edited in LA, you know, and like we had a really good time making that video. And we threw everything and the kitchen sink into it. And I mean, pretty much that's what it is. It's just like the kitchen, it's a kitchen sink video of like any concept that you have. You know, for me, with it being like my most expensive video, it's like a play on words for me. So everything was a chase in that video. You know, I mean, it was like a foot chase, a car chase, a boat chase, a helicopter chase. My name is Chase. The reporter's name was Rose Chase, dedicated to my mom, you know. So, but that's pretty much, you know, where I was. I mean, you know, all these videos are available on YouTube. I did, like I said, you know, have some UK videos stuff, but I feel like my time may have overrun. But I was just asked to kind of give an overview of Innovative Challenge, and I thought going retro was really an interesting thing for you guys, because when are you going to have a chance to see that kind of stuff? So, any final questions there?
It's more about, like I said, we've had the digital implosion, like with production and with sort of where the actual finished product goes. Where we sort of said, like, the what are music videos there for at the moment? How would you market them now, like, with the internet? What would you say if you had an absolutely kick-ass music video? What would you do with it now? Because, like you usually, like, send off to Channel U and stuff like that, AKA, whatever it's called now. You still say that's a good option when you put more emphasis on promoting it online and stuff like that.
Put it on your Facebook page, that's where it works. Channel U and AKA, nobody's watching that anymore. Mm-hmm. You know, there are no video channels anymore. Do the investigation yourself, you will find that to be the case. I mean, like, the thing about it is like, nobody's making, record labels gave up on videos of like 5 years ago. You know, that's why there's no money in it. You know, but artists need to sell themselves. So your best bet is, like, if you look at an artist, like, I would ask you to type in a girl named Birdie, right? she has a song called Help the People, yeah? And she is a songstress, and she's doing like YouTube videos, and she blew up, man. She blew up massively. This is why the record labels don't pay for videos anymore, because people will find you if you put it out there. Your best bet is to do a video and put it onto YouTube, Facebook, and all of that, and market it through the digital streams or social networks, because record labels don't care. There's no options anymore. Remember you had TRL?